Hi everybody, first I want to start the video off by saying to Shane Dawson, if you don't know who that is, you must be living under a rock, because everyone knows who he is, even if you're not on YouTube. And let me adjust the camera, there we go. His grandma passed away, I believe, on the 4th, so my condolences and thoughts go out to him and his family. It really sucks, especially to lose a grandma that you're really close to. But yeah, my thoughts and my prayers go out to him and his family. And just remember, she's in a better place. She's not in pain anymore. So that's a good thing. On a little lighter note, I got to go to the 30 Seconds to Mars concert here in my hometown. It was amazing. Although I'm not too happy about what Jared Leto did to his hair. The pink, hot pink mohawk doesn't do so well on him. But he wanted to do it. First band was called Neon Trees. They're not that bad, but they kind of make me think of the 80s. They're very 80s with the way they dress and like their hair and things like that. But they're a pretty good band. I mean, they hold the audience's attention. Granted, it's with things that they shouldn't, but they do hold an audience's attention. Let's see. Then there was Mute Math, the band that is a bit more well-known than Neon Trees. They were okay. I've never been overly fascinated with Mute Math, but they do put on a good live show. So, kudos to them on that. 30 Seconds to Mars did amazing. They had a lot of fun, like they always do. Jared Leto decided he was going to be brave and he was going to try to sing while wading through the pit. Ended up having to stop the song because a bunch of girls got knocked over. He helped a couple of them up and pretty much said, you know what, if someone gets knocked down, help them back up. Then he decided to completely turn his direction and head towards my direction, because I was standing by some stairs. Unfortunately, I got knocked over too and almost got completely trampled, and I was in a sling on top of everything because of, let's see if I could adjust the camera a little. I can't really see it too well anymore because the doctor did a really good job, but that little cut on my arm is actually from a recent surgery that I had to have. They had to put a bone graft in there because of a big old bone cyst in my shoulder, so. But it's getting better, so that's a good thing. Let's see. What else did I write down? Oh, yeah. But I got knocked over and pretty much trampled. Jared Leto tried to help me and another girl back up, but as soon as security could grab him, they did. They put him back on the stage, but at least I got up, and being knocked over forced me forward so much that I actually got to be up in the front row. Granted, I was on the side, but I was still up in the front row. That was nice. Let's see. Oh yeah, I know I haven't posted anything. I knew I was going to start posting things about my medical history and all that stuff so people could learn a little more about it and hopefully see that you're not going to get sick by hanging out with me. You're not going to get sick by talking to me. So my videos that are going to be titled My Life, it'll be an entire series of all sorts of stuff that I go through. But those will be up soon, or at least the first one. I want to thank my friend Mindy. She is the one that took me to the concert because I don't drive. And I told her, you know what, I'll pay for the tickets, I'll buy dinner, I'll buy you a drink when we get there. And we went to the concert. We had a blast, as far as I know. I know I did. I think she did. But I wanted to thank her on this video, because if it weren't for her, I wouldn't have been able to go. So, thank you, Mindy. And hopefully we have more bands in common and we can hang out again and go to another concert sometime soon. Let's see. What else? Oh, I have a friend. His name is Georgie. And congratulations to him. He passed boot camp. He, like, is in tip-top shape now. And he wasn't beforehand. So I am so proud of him for that. He is also going to be stationed in Hawaii. So lucky him. And then, on the same topic of military, I have a friend named Lee. Him and his wife moved up to Alaska because that's where he was stationed after he passed boot camp. And they're coming home for good. He is permanently being placed here from Alaska. So we're all excited because we can't wait to see him again. We all miss him. And I wanted to make a little mention about what's happening in the Gulf of Mexico right now. One of the oil drill things that they had there, I'm giving a brief overview because I'm not sure how many people actually pay attention, but it's causing a very, very, very bad, environmental issue right now, and I'm hoping whatever they do, they're going to be able to fix it, because it's causing major problems and it's only going to get worse. So I mean, if they start up any funds, or if they have people go down to start helping, try and figure out a way you can help, because it's something that's going to take a lot of work. Let's see. I wanted to thank everyone that's been helping me lately. I can't lift anything because of my shoulder surgery, so I've had friends who have carried stuff for me. I've had friends who have... I have four friends in particular. Sorry, dry throat. But... four friends in particular, my friend Andy, my friend Sam, which is Andy's girlfriend, my friend Megan, and she's like an older sister to me. My mom is like pretty much adopted her. And then her friend, which I apologize to him because I can't remember his name right now. I've only met him like twice. But they all came to visit me in the hospital after I had my surgery on my shoulder. They came after my friend Andy got off work, and he gets off work at like midnight. So, I mean, and they could have all just been home, relaxing, whatever. But they came and saw me for like 2 hours, and that made me feel so much better. And my... big sister Megan actually helped me put up my hair because I couldn't put up my hair and all of that. And then when I got out of the hospital on Friday, Megan and I were doing the LARP thing, and this was one of the ones we hold in a hotel because it's a 2-night game, and we shared a room. She helped me do my hair and makeup. She even helped me wash my hair because it was a little difficult to do with only one arm. And yeah, she just helped me in multiple ways. And I wanted to thank everybody that's been helping me for that. Other than that, though, that's pretty much it. And hopefully my first video should